Arnab, I can barely hear you, but from what I gather of your question, you know, whatever legal consequences which are there, I'm sure you know he's facing it. And if there has been any omission on his part, the party does not at all support it.
A member of parliament slaps a government doctor. Sorry, and not just that, says I will kill you. This incident takes place in a civil hospital. And because the doctor is busy with another case, he can't attend to the MP. So the MP goes with his supporters and slaps the doctor and says, I will kill you. Instead of punishing him, you reward him by giving him a ticket once again. You bring him back to parliament. You're drunk on par. Mr. Sinha, don't give me a legal response.
No, Arnab, that may not be a fair statement.
Well, Mr. Sinha, the
proceedings will go on, and if there has been any omission on his part, the party does not at all condone it, and he will face the legal consequences. But just, you know, coming to a pertinent question that you raised.
What we are doing is, frankly, all of you are using the fact that
coming to a pertinent question that you raised. What happened, Arnab, just coming back to a very pertinent query that you raised. What happened in Jammu and Kashmir was absolutely...
No, why don't you tell me what your party did? I want to ask each one of you about what you do.
Why the stoic silence from...
Why the stoic silence from you on your case?
That is a pertinent query that you raised. And there has been no response from MC. And repeatedly, you know, we have been... Repeatedly, Arnab, in Jammu and Kashmir, we have seen these instances happening. And it is absolutely, you know, condemnable that nobody has come forward to express a word of regret or an apology. All that they were asking for was an apology. And if they indeed think that, you know, there was some omission shortcoming on part of the minister, what was the problem in apologizing and expressing regret?
You know,
for
Mr. Aman Sinha, you all want to point fingers at each other. Yes, R.K. Mishra. Yes, Mr. Mishra.
Aman Sinha.
No, that was the subject of the discussion today.
Aman, listen. Subject of the discussion was...
No, it's all right, I am listening. There is no need to shout.
And the arrogance of politicians.
If we are all vouching for dignity and decorum in public life, we can have a dignified debate at least.
Aman, please listen. If you know this member of parliament, and if he has gone and slapped one medical officer, that means he's a gunda. Now, if he is a gunda, should you give him parliament ticket? And in Gujarat, you can make even a person who has no political background, he will win because it's Mr. Modi's state. What was the compulsion to give a ticket to a gunda?
And Mr. Sinha, understand this very correctly. Having patronized and encouraged and rewarded gundas in your party,
correct.
What right do you have to talk about gundas in other parties? You all have your own resident gunda.
Arnab. You know, if I can.
Some of you have more gundas, some of you have less gundas, but you all have your own resident gundas, and you are not doing anything to control them, Mr. Sinha. This is a very serious question.
No, we are doing. For the first time, our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, has given a vision of how to, you know, decriminalize, you know, politics and politics.
Wonderful, good question. I'm showing pictures here.
System whereby
I'm showing pictures here of October 2012. No, I'm showing pictures of October 2012 of a man called Vittal Radadia caught on CCTV pointing a gun.
We are coming up with a proposed amendment in, you know, we are going to have fast track courts for. Politicians who are involved in, you know,
you want to create fast track courts to clear politicians.
Whosoever is guilty, he will be punished.
Mr. Sinha,
giving ticket is a right of the party president. You do not need a judge. Why do you give ticket to gundas? If you don't give the ticket to gundas, other people who get elected will not become.
You are entitled to draw your own blanket sweeping conclusions. I am not getting into that. But if anybody is convicted, there are clear provisions.
Representation of People Act,
and he stands disqualified. So please do not pass your blanket sweeping judgment.
Do not avoid the question.
It is not a question of avoiding the question. It is not your opinion that counts. It is the opinion of the court, the law of the land that counts. How can you make a sweeping judgment without even giving somebody...
Today every political party and Salman Soz also raises his hand out there.
One at a time, Mr. Soz. And I gave you an instance that for the first time...
I have given examples to...
For the first time in history of India, there has been a structured effort... to
Mr. Sinha, don't give me theoretical answers.
Politicians,
don't give me theoretical answers.
What is the difficulty?
Mr. Sinha, don't give me theoretical answers. You and I are in the real world, and neither are you nor am I a character in Alice in Wonderland. The question is very simple. And now let me deal with the Shiv Sena.
And I insist all parties and media support when we come up with that proposal.
I insist all political parties are the same. Salman doesn't like it, Mr. Baig doesn't like it. Look at the Shiv Sena.
No, you didn't say political.
Look at the Shiv Sena. Look at the Shiv Sena. Maybe you set the right example for the way, maybe it was because of the way the Shiv Sena MPs behaved. Maybe the J&K minister saw the way the Shiv Sena MPs behaved and took an example from that. Mr. Prem Shukla, you're the one who set the nation talking with what Rajan Vichare, your member of parliament, did in Maharashtra Sadan. The most recent example of hooliganism and bad behavior.
Arnab, you already issued an order against us.
No, I haven't. I made an observation.
So please allow. Your observation is an order. I am feeling it. You have given an order on this debate.
Certainly not.
Order of the debate is that we are gundas.
I have said every party has some gundas.
You have given that.
I have not said you are a gunda. I have said all parties have some gundas.
This is my humble plea. Now this is you are not said to me. This is my humble plea. Even in the criminal procedure code, they are forced as first. If there is some prima facie evidence, you can file an FIR, then it will be investigated. If you will find there is some content in the
allegation. Okay, so do you feel there was prima facie evidence when your MP was force feeding a person who told you he was fasting?
There is no prima facie evidence.
There is no prima facie evidence.
If there was any prima facie evidence, Commissioner of Maharashtra Sadan, Mr. Bipin Malik should be blamed. He must have filed a case against Rajan Vichare.
But
he has never dared to file a case. After that also, you are convicting us.
I am asking you some very relevant questions.
This is humbleness. But you are already lashing us. Then you are gundas.
The citizens of India are now sick and tired of this.
You are
all over on TV right now. I can see what is happening. And yet you believe that you want a conviction. What is this? People are children.
Already convicted us. You are ready to give punishment.
You are saying
that our people are gundas.
I am asking a question.
How many gunda cases you have gotten?
I am asking a very relevant question, and please wake up, Mr. Prem Shukla. Prem Shukla ji, थोड़ा आप समझ लीजिए कि ये 2014 है, देश बदल चुकी है, और आप जिस तरह से आप करते थे पहले अभी नहीं कर सकते.
पूरी तरह से
आप नहीं कर सकते. जैसे कि मैं कहना चाहता हूँ,
हमने किया ही नहीं है.
ये तो सारे देश ने देखा है आपने क्या किया, क्या नहीं किया है. आप में अगर हिम्मत नहीं है उस बात को मानने की, तो मैं क्या करूं.
आरोप साबित नहीं हुए. एक व्यक्ति के अपने आक्रोश को आपने उसका दर्प कह दिया.
Now, I'll,
एक व्यक्ति को जनप्रतिनिधि होने के बाद भी उसे भोजन नहीं मिलता. वो कहता टेस्ट कर लो.
मिस्टर शुक्ला, नाउ लेट मी गो टू द अदर्स.
गुंडा कह दिया.
लेट मी गो टू द अदर्स.
मैं आपको सुन रहा हूं. ये मेरी अगर लोकतांत्रिक व्यवस्था.
मिस्टर शुक्ला, नाउ आई थिंक यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी, एंड यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड योर राइट्स, एंड यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड योर प्रिविलेजेस. यू सर्टेनली डोंट अंडरस्टैंड योर. नाउ आई हैव यस, आरके मिश्रा इज कमिंग इनटू द डिबेट. One minute. There are four examples, ladies and gentlemen. And should I open the phone lines tonight? I give four examples. And I'm opening up the phone lines. Prem Shukla ji, zara logo ko bhi suniye. Log bhi kuch kehna chahte hain news hour mein. Listen to them. I give four examples. Bad behavior by a government minister in Jammu and Kashmir who insults and completely humiliates a senior government official. Government officials go on strike. Congress party, an MLA in Karnataka threatens to strip policemen and beats them up when they object to his party going after midnight. No action by the Congress party. The BJP, a member of parliament says, I will kill you. A government doctor, he says, I will kill you. And then goes on to slap him because he does not attend to him. No action. That person is actually rewarded by giving him a party ticket. The Shiv Sena, less said the better, uses their clout to force and shove food down someone's throat. I have revealed four examples with four political parties, and I'm very sorry if you're all feeling very hurt tonight. I can tell you, the people of this country are feeling far more hurt than you. Far more hurt than you. And the people of this country have had absolutely enough with this kind of behavior. We have our first caller this evening from Baroda. And it's Janil from Baroda. Good evening, Janil. Good evening, Janil. Prem Shukla ji.
Good evening, good evening.
Logo ki awaaz suniye.
Yeah, yeah. I wanted to ask those politicians over there, can the common man in India can expect justice in those cases where high-profile people are involved?
Good point, Janil. Let Salman take that.
Yeah.
Because he didn't explain what happened. In the case that I gave him from Karnataka, he didn't have a word in response. And obviously, there was no action in that case either. Yes, Salman, take that. That question goes to you. Well, Keep it specific.
I want to keep it specific. Arnab, I want to simply say, I want to make some two specific points. There is no doubt that all political parties have, people or politicians who are not behaving properly. There is no doubt about that.
Salman, please let me finish.
For God's sake, let me finish.
Arnab, at the same time, you said
that all politicians, you talked about all politicians being like this. I asked you at that time to take it back, because I never do that. There are so many decent people involved. You generalized. Mr. Salman, I want to say something to you.
I'm sorry, you're creating a bad impression about everybody. We're not all bad.
Okay?
Mr. Soz, the bad ones should be taken to task, but don't go after everybody.
You're generalizing. I'm sorry.
Mr. Soz, now I'll take the next question, but I just want to tell you here, I'm not used to people pointing their fingers like that, and people, viewers of Newsa will not appreciate your pointing your fingers like that. And the second point is, what I've said is political parties have an unusually high level of patience in dealing with gundas in their own parties. They should take action against them. I don't know what I said, so which was wrong, and I'm certainly not taking
you
it back.
I'm saying all political parties are the same in their high tolerance level towards gundas.
You have no answer to my specific question, and please...
You're not responding to what I asked you to do. I am asking you, do you have gundas in your party?
Okay, so Mr. Soz, let me ask you. Vijayanand Kashapanavar, Congress MLA from Hungund, and his supporters allegedly attacked two police constables and threatened to strip them at a lounge bar on June 2nd, 2014, when the constables objected to a party that is continuing past midnight. When the constables begin clicking pictures, the legislators who are partying hurl abuses at them before manhandling them and say they will strip them. I'm asking you tonight, is this man a gunda? Is the man who did this a gunda?
That is gundaism.
So have you thrown him out? Have you thrown this gunda from your party?
Have you thrown the gunda from your party?
Have you thrown the gunda out of your party? Do you have the courage to do that? And if you don't have the courage to do that, Mr. Soz, don't point your finger at me on national television. Our next caller this evening is Vishwanath, and he's calling from Bangalore. And that's the kind of arrogance I've had, and all people of this country have had enough about. No more arrogance. Yes, Mr. Vishwanath. Ashok Pandit, I'll come to you.
Who's arrogant?
I'm giving you specific examples. Vishwanath.
My view in this subject is, irrespective of party-wise, this arrogance has become the time of the day. It is not only deplorable, it has to be curtailed at once. Because if this continues, then there will be a fear for the electorate. To the politicians, how to handle them, how to approach them, rather.
Absolutely. I'm completely there with you. I have a lot of callers here now, but R.K. Mishra, I am not really seeing a serious rethinking going on within the parties. All they are saying is that why are you throwing specific examples at us? They're all isolated examples. I don't think so. R.K. Mishra, two minutes on the debate, it's R.K. Mishra's turn.
Arnab, I think I agree with many of these people when they say they are stray elements. The problem is they are not just stray elements. They could be 10% in some parties, they could be 30%. But if you throw such people out,
exactly,
even if one person, you will set an example that other next time no gundaism will be allowed in the party.
Exactly.
Will not become gundas. Why are you not doing it? That is a question source does not need to get angry. Aman Sinha does not.
Because of selfish political interest.
Does not need to get angry. Yes. Please do this.
I don't agree.
For the sake of your politics of this country, democracy of this country.
And that's a question.
But I agree with you.
Well, you know,
I'm in agreement.
Don't agree with me. Take some action. We have one more caller. Brojo, our next caller. Brojo, and did the BJP have answers tonight? No. Did the BJP take action against an MP who slaps a government doctor and threatens to kill him? No. Did the BJP welcome Vitthal Radadia into the party after he behaved like a gunda? Yes. Was he rewarded? Was he felicitated? Yes. So how is the BJP different, Aman Sinha? You know, you're not different in a manifesto. You're different through your actions, Mr. Sinha, and I haven't seen those. I'm not getting the audio line with you. I'm going to take one more caller instead then. And our last caller is Brojo. He's calling from?
Bangalore.
Bangalore. Yes, Brojo. Good evening.
Yeah. Good evening, Mr. Arnab.
Good evening.
Can any of these political leaders sitting here live on Times Now promise that none of them have gunda elements in their parties? Live, can they tell online right away that they don't have any gundas in their party?
Mehboob Beg, take that. Mehboob Beg, take that question.
What's that, Arnab?
The question is...
Can you repeat it?
Bro Joe, a viewer from Bangalore says, can you assure him and the viewers of Newsa, can any of the political parties here assure him that they don't have a single gunda element in their party? Can
no,
you?
That will be wrong to say. No, that will be wrong to say. I won't make a wrong statement on national television anywhere.
So why do you tolerate them, Mr.
Beg? No, there are some bad people, there are some good people, and we
need to
take corrective measures and take them very quickly before people lose their faith in the system.
I'm not convinced. Yes, Ashok Pandit wants to quickly rebut.
Arnab, I wanted to rebut Salman and Mehboob Beg, both of them, that your silence on gundaism in your party makes you a party to the crime.
All
if you
right.
React to it. It
totally.
You become a target to the crime.
Totally short of time.
There is no saying that I'm a good man. I'm a good man. He's a bad man.
Totally short of time, and Salman Soz and Ashok Pandit can debate it after the show.
The parties and the BJP.
You next time don't force us to raise these uncomfortable questions. Take away the opportunity. Take away the opportunity from us to ask these questions. But till you give us the opportunity, we will. I thank you all for joining me on debate number 2 on the News Hour tonight.